Dogumentary TV, producing the best breed documentaries on YouTube.
Hi, I'm Alfonso Beltran.
And I'm Gracie Beltran.
And this is Zeus. And we just wanted something large, more for security, more for protection of the home. And we came across the breed of the Cane Corsos.
There was some home invasions that were happening in our area. Zeus's birthday is March 30th. He was born in 2022. He's 17 months, going to be 18 months soon. Yeah.
He weighs around 170 pounds. We saw him when he was 5 weeks old. We brought him home at 3 months. So we've been with him since he was basically 5 weeks old.
We did a lot of research on the Cane Corsos and liked that they have that. Their first line of defense really is their appearance. So, you know, we were attracted to the look, but in addition, a lot of the characteristics, right? They're super protective, but loyal. They can be good family dogs. We have two small kids, and he does great around them. When we were in the market for a Corso, we had some friends that had given us some like feedback on their experience with their Corso. And one of the things that stood out to me was make sure that you get to know the temperament of the parents that they're coming from.
Baby boy.
That's my baby.
The breeder that we got him from has four Corsos of his own, and our kids were in there interacting and, you know, just petting the dog. So
four huge Corsos running around. Yeah. It's a 5-year-old and a 7-year-old kid. You know, just amazing to see, just knowing the temperament of the animal.
We also established a really good relationship with our breeder. We've continued. We have like dog play dates. So Zeus was one of two puppies from his litter. So he was really socialized as a puppy along with his sister. So we just thought it would be nice. He does live local to us. So we thought it would be nice to continue a relationship with them. So when Zeus does his visits, it's his grandma, his aunt, His mom and his sister. We've made him a part of our family. Right. So any trip that we go on, you know, we is it a dog friendly place? Can we take Zeus? If we can't take Zeus, where is he gonna go? You know, and we did have a boarding facility that, you know, we had boarded him out a few times, but we have a family member that will come stay with him. So, you know, really every part of our life does work around this dog because he's very loyal to us, but also he does get a little of, how would you describe it? He gets maybe separation anxiety.
Yeah.
Because their instincts are to wonder where they're, to look for their family and to protect them at all times. With this breed, you have to consider all aspects of time, patience, money.
It's not a dog you would get and just put in the backyard.
Actions are really funny when we take Zeus out. He does attract a lot of attention. You know, with a lot of people, you know, if they're not familiar with the breed, what kind of breed is it? What kind of dog is that? He's so huge, or, you know, is he friendly? But yeah, there was one time we were out in Calico and there was a tour bus that had pulled up and we had just gotten Zeus out of the car, and my daughter and I were just standing there with Zeus, and these people, it was like one after, you know, each person that'd get out, you were just getting a different reaction. But we get all types, but we had one guy just wow, and you know, his wow never ended. It was just continuous and we just laughed. But it is true, you know, you don't really see a lot of dogs this size out in public, you know, out in Calico, ghost town, you know, just to explore. But that's just part of what we said, where yeah, we've just made them a part of our family.
Daily basis, I teach them not to be scared of the animal, not to be fear of the animal. Put their hands in his mouth, feed him out of their palm of the hand, take the dog food bowl away from him, put it back to him, and make sure that he's not growling at them or being aggressive towards them, because he's already outgrown them. He's a weight size and just height and weight. So I never want my kids to feel dangerous around them. My kid's safety is always my priority. But he's never had any issues where they can sit here and eat chicken nuggets and watch a movie, and he does the same thing, just waits. So they offer him something, but he won't go and eat their food or growl at them or try to be aggressive, show his dominancy by trying to be aggressive towards them. But that's something they practice. I have them do it, go get the dog bowl, take it away from him while he's eating, put it back. And he doesn't do anything, but just repetitiveness as well. And just a reminder that we're the masters, we're his masters. We gotta make sure that our kids also as well do the same thing with them.
Establish boundaries, yeah.
He never, ever shown aggression to anybody like that. And we stay on top of it too as well. We never step away from him. We're always there within 2 feet from him. We never let him feel like he's that free as well. He wakes up with us. I'll give you an example of just daily routine. He checks in the kids' bedrooms, make sure they're there, make sure they're awake, make sure they're doing what they're doing before he walks downstairs. Once he comes downstairs, he goes, I feed him usually in the mornings once. He gets 3 cups in the morning. So he goes, eats his food. He's done eating, wants to come back in the house and just wants to see what the family is doing. He gets ready. Sometimes he gets sneaky. He tries to jump into the car and we take the kids to school. So he goes on car rides. But that's just basically his morning. That's just the morning time. That's all he does. But we bring him home or we'll stop by a dog park, just take him out, and we just practice with them, train them as well. Just repetitiveness is very important on these breeds, especially when they're large, and just consistency as well.
Yeah, when we first got him, at that time I was in school, and a concern of ours was leaving him at home for, 8 hours a day. So we really worked around Zeus's schedule. He would come home on his breaks, 15 minutes, take him out for a quick walk. If I was driving home, or if I was on a longer break from school, I'd come home, let him out of his crate. So we've always worked our schedules really around Zeus. Our daughter is a softball player. He's known around the park. He Zeus is another family member. One place that Zeus really enjoys going is to the dog beach out in Huntington. So because of his size, I always say that he's discriminated against. Immediately, there's people that are looking, they're curious to know whether or not Zeus is, friendly to other dogs. And usually it's the opposite. Is your dog friendly to our dog? Because we have put that time and effort into him.
We've taken him to several dog parks around the area, and every time we take him, he gets a bad rep right away. They assume like, oh, because he's drooling as well. He's running around, oh, that dog's aggressive. They'll ask us, is he friendly? Like, yeah, what about your dog?
I think we've done a good job with taking Zeus out, that, when a dog is reactive to him, he does keep calm. He's kind of like assesses, is this something I need to be reactive to? And I think he goes off of like what we feel too. So we haven't, thank God, we have never had like any instances where we've had a dog really attack him. That's never happened. I told my daughter after our first dog beach visit that I was gonna try to start a like large dog or Cane Corso dog meetup at the beach, so they can just play with dogs their size, because they are large, they do run fast, they can trample another dog, and dogs will naturally react. So, again, I think I'm just always trying to focus on protecting their name, right? The Cane Corso name, and giving them just a safe place to go play.
Yeah, we brought
this is the chicken nugget.
Yeah. Holy shit, his head is as big as my Frenchie.
Oh boy.
What's up, buddy?
He's so chill.
How old is he?
17 months.
Zeus, we definitely pride ourselves with the work that we've put into him. When we take him places, he's very docile.
Just repetitiveness and just training him, just knowing he's not allowed to jump on the furniture, not allowed to get over here. It's
And our discipline has never been physical. It's really, we've done click training, we've done
treats.
He's very food driven. Yeah, that is like a big one with Zeus. But also playing, we've noticed that, he loves to play with toys. So we will, when we see that he's eager to play, we make him, follow command. So we make him wait, and then, we'll throw the toy and then we allow him to go get it. And there's sometimes when we don't do that. So we let him be a dog, but we also still continue to establish who's in charge, through anything that he enjoys. He allows people to come and, pet him and get close to him. He's just, he's a good example of what putting your time and your effort into a Corso. Zeus exemplifies like what we've done, by working with him. I would say the one con of a Cane Corso is like their stubbornness. Oh my gosh. And it's not in a negative way, but like if he's gonna lay down, he is going to lay down. And if it's not anything that really excites him, you know, calling him, he might not always come if he's comfortable. And it's just part of their stubbornness. But, you know, I think he's smart enough to know our tone of voice. So if it's serious enough, you know, Zeus, get up, he gets up. Otherwise, no, it's nap time.
Right now is nap
and
time.
And snoring right now is nap time.
So I would recommend the breed as well. Also, people, when they ask us, we have them out, like, oh, would you guys recommend this for my family? I have a 3-year-old. I was like, I'll show an example, just my son. He's 5, and my son will be walking him or holding him. And I was like, this is how he's with them around all the time. So it is a family animal, but just the same thing as my wife says, you have to put the time into it as well. It's not something that you get put in the backyard and that's it. It's a dog.
We did train him ourselves. You know, but there are a lot of resources also. You know, we did come across some Cane Corso like training videos online, and we did try different techniques that work, you know, to see what worked for him. So it is trial and error, but also you have very limited space for error because you don't want it to ever go a different direction. One thing that we've always said is if we notice that he was
aggressive,
that, you know, we wouldn't be able to keep them, you know, because a dog ultimately at the end of the day is a dog. So, you know, you consistency and making sure that you are putting time into what your training, you know, is going to keep you okay with your dog. Yeah. We're the Beltrans, and it has been our joy sharing our experience about our Cane Corso.